In this video, I want to explain how to estimate the rate of evaporation from the standard evaporation pan. An evaporation pan is located in the weather station. It's cylindrical in shape with a diameter of 4 feet or 121.9 centimeters, and it is 10 inches deep or 25.4 centimeters. So the diameter is this one, which is 4 feet, and the depth is 10 inches. Right? It has a steering pole. The steering pole is here. There's this partition with an opening here so that this water can move from here to this place. This is a steering pole, and it has a hook. At the tip of this hook, it is the datum level. Alright, and the evaporation pan is covered with a protective wire mesh, which is painted with aluminium paint, and the wire mesh keeps away birds and a lot of litter from interfering with our measurements. The pan rests on wooden poles. These are wooden poles, preferably cedar poles. The inner surface of the pan is painted black, and the pan is filled with water up to the datum level. Now it appears in the diagram. Right? So depending on the amount of evaporation and precipitation, this water level may rise above this datum level, or may drop below the datum level. Right? And when the water level rises above the datum level, we usually remove that water to maintain the datum level. And when it goes below the datum level, we add more water to maintain the datum level. We do that by using a special cup, a standard cup. Okay, this cup, one cup causes a change in depth of 0.5 millimeters. So when you add a cup in this pan or remove a cup of water from this pan, there is a change in depth of 0.5 millimeters. And we can use that measurement, the depth that is 0.5 millimeters and this diameter, to calculate the capacity of this cup. So using the formula for volume, which is equal to pi r squared times height, this pi times the diameter, 121.92 divided by 2, to get the radius squared, times the depth the cup causes, which is 0.5 millimeters or 0.05 centimeters. So when you work out this one, you get about 584 cubic centimeters as the capacity of this cup. But what is more important here is that the cup causes a change in depth of 0.5 millimeters. Let's see how you can compute the amount of evaporation from these measurements. There are three possibilities. Okay, rainfall may exceed evaporation, or rainfall or evaporation may exceed the amount of rainfall, or evaporation may be the same as the amount of rainfall measured. So in the first case, where rainfall is more than evaporation, we find that the water level will rise above the datum level. This is the datum level, and the water level is above. Even though we had some evaporation, the water would have dropped. The water level dropped from this datum to this point because of evaporation. But because of more rainfall, the water level rose above the datum level. So what we do, when the rainfall exceeds evaporation, we remove this amount of water and count the number of cups we have removed. Right? So because one cup causes a change in depth of 0.5 millimeters, we multiply 0.5 times the number of cups removed. So in this particular case, evaporation is equal to the amount of rainfall measured subtract 0.5 times the number of cups removed. Okay, number two, when evaporation is more than rainfall, when evaporation exceeds the amount of rainfall. So in this case, we find that this being the datum level, we find that the water level is here because we had more evaporation. There was loss of water through evaporation, so the level dropped from here to this point. But because of some rainfall, the water level rose from here to this point. So to get the amount of evaporation here, we use this formula. Evaporation is equal to the amount of rainfall plus 0.5 times the number of cups added. Because we have to add water in the pan so that we maintain the datum level. That is when evaporation exceeded rainfall. So the cups added is n times 0.5. So in this equation, this is how you can calculate evaporation. In the last situation, is where evaporation is equal to the amount of rainfall measured. So this is the datum level. There was evaporation. There was also rainfall. And the two are equal. So the water level is equal to the datum level. So there's no cup added or removed. So in this case, the amount of evaporation is equal to the amount of rainfall measured using the rain gauge in the weather station. That is how we are able to measure evaporation and compute a value for the amount of evaporation. If you find this video helpful, kindly subscribe to see more videos about weather measurements and other things. Thank you.